Good morning, guys. Today, I will show you how to measure the output signal and input signal of this crystal oscillator. We will see the parameters and likewise the EF room. Let's see. This is the crystal oscillator. It has a frequency of 8 megahertz. See, it has a frequency of 8 megahertz. Now we'll see the parameters. See the parameters. See, the parameters of this crystal oscillator. This volt maximum is equals to 1.76 volt. Volt minimum equals to 80.0 millivolt. Volt peak to peak 1.76 volt. The volt tap 1.63 volts. Volt is a bias equals 329 millivolts. Volts ampere equals 1.32 volts. This volt average equals 964 millivolts. Volt root mean squared 1.12 volts. This is volt this period equals 126.0 nanoseconds. The frequency is 8 megahertz. The rise of signal from zero to the top equals 42.00 nanoseconds. This is the uprise of the signal, while the fall is equals to 36.00 nanoseconds. It means the rise of the signal is faster than fall. The width is 60 nanoseconds. Duty cycle is 46.4% positive duty cycle, positive wave, while the negative wave of duty cycle is 52.2. This is the parameters of this crystal oscillator. Now let's see here at the EF room. This is the EF room. See the EF room. This is the EF room. See, this is the signal of EF room. See, EF room. Now we can see it too, the EF room. Its volt maximum equals to 5.2 volts. Volt minimum 960 millivolt. Volt peak peak to peak 6.16 volts, volt chop 5 volts, volt base I mean 120 millivolts, 120 millivolts. See, it's fluctuating. See, volt amperes equals 4.9 volts. These volts average 88 millivolts. Volt root means square, 80.0 millivolts. This period period 1.5, sorry, it does not appear. I will, this is what the period is 1 millisecond. Frequency is 1.238 megahertz. The rise of this 12.00 milliseconds, the fall 404.0 milliseconds, the width is 400 milliseconds, positive width. The negative width is 412 milliseconds. Positive duty cycle 50%, negative duty cycles 51%. So this is the parameters of crystal oscillator and the is a EF room. So when through of this we will know what's the parameter of this spare parts, the signal of spare or signal in and out of this. That's why it is good to have oscilloscope so that we can understand very well the what's going on the spare parts. Okay guys, thank you very much for watching of this video.